the 63rd example and what is said. The following parameters of the arrangement in figure 1.1 are available. The angle is alpha. The plane forms with horizontal. The coefficient of friction is K between the body M1 and the inclined plane. The masses of the pulley and the threads as well as the friction in the pulley are negligible. Assuming both bodies to be motionless at the initial moment, find the ratio M2 by M1 at which body M2 first starts coming down. So in order to come down, the weight M2g is acting in this direction, while the component of the weight M1g sin alpha is acting here. So in order, the condition for M2 to go down must be, so M1 should go up. It means the friction on M1 will be in the downward direction, which is coefficient of friction into N1. So this is K into Mg cos alpha is the action on the inclined surface. From FD you will see that Mg cos alpha is the action. So reaction is this. So M2G must be greater than, it must be greater than M1G sin alpha plus frictional force KMG cos alpha. So M2G must be greater than M1 into G in bracket sin alpha plus K cos alpha. The G get cancelled. So M2 upon M1 must be greater than sin alpha plus K cos alpha. So that must be the ratio of M2 by M1 so that M2 will start coming down. Second, M2 starts going up. Now if M2 is starts going up, then in that case, let's take the diagram again on this page for the second numerical. Now in the second condition is that the M2 should go up. It means M1 will go down. So the weight M2G is acting here. The weight M1G sin alpha is acting here. The frictional force is acting upward. So the condition is that M1G sin alpha must be greater than the friction plus M2G. So M1G sin alpha must be greater than K1 M1G cos alpha, that is the action, plus M2G. Let's take this term on this side. So it will be M1G in bracket sin alpha minus K cos alpha greater than M2G. So G and G will get cancelled out. And again, you will see that sin alpha minus K cos alpha must be greater than M2 by M1, or M2 by M1 must be less than this parameter. That's the answer for the B part. Now in the third part, at rest. Now in order that the system, to be at rest, then in that case, there will be two different conditions. First of all, M2G must be equal to T and T must be equal to this plus friction. So first condition, M2G, okay, must be less than M1G sin alpha plus K M1G cos alpha. So in that case, M2 upon M1 must be less than sin alpha plus K cos alpha. Now second, this is the condition so that it should not go down or it should not slide up. But it may happen that it will go down and it will come up. So for that, the condition must be m1g must be less than friction km1g cos alpha plus m2g. So m1g, this will be on this side, minus k m1g cos alpha must be less than m2g. So m2 upon m1, so g get cancelled, m1 can be taken as common and it can be sent on this side, so it should be equal to this must be m1g sin alpha. So this will be sin alpha minus k cos alpha. So now combining these two condition, that m2 by m1 must be greater than this and less than this, so you will see that the condition is sin alpha minus k cos alpha. So m2 by m1 must be greater than this and must be less than this, sin alpha k plus k cos alpha, sin alpha plus k cos alpha. And that's the answer to the third part of the question. Thank you.